Many are the unforgettable features that place Cross River State at the indisputable pinnacle of African safari world. The state's rich natural heritage, the startling varieties of landscape, its awe-inspiring sceneries, its sublime culture, its remarkable history, people, and cities. The capital, Calabar, has always been known to have one of the richest histories in sub-Saharan Africa. Guests can either begin or end their tours in this beautiful and hospitable city. Perhaps you are a people person and you feel like catching a glimpse of the local culture. Or perhaps you are more interested in the history and would like to know more about the people from its rich historical past. Calabar is a popular and central meeting place for all who either live around the Atlantic coast or come down for trade or even visit from upcountry. The city has also played host to early pioneers, international traders, missionaries, and colonialists. The foundation of the modern-day Calabar was laid in the 1880s when it hosted the government of Niger Protectorate, the Southern Protectorate, and later the Oil River Protectorate. The first-time visitor is treated to exciting sights that move from ancient to modern. This beautiful and seemingly innocent marina, for instance, goes down in history as the departure point for over 31% of slaves that left African shores during the transatlantic slave trade era. You will almost certainly stop by the famous tombstone of Mary Slessor, a Scottish female missionary who led the movement that eventually put an end to killing of twins in the old Calabar. This historic site lies on the hilly street of Old Calabar Town. A small trip to Apam Okoyon takes the visitors to Mary Slessor's caravan. So much of Calabar, and indeed Nigerian history, is wrapped up in this little two-bedroom habitation with a veranda, a store, and a parlor, which the indigents fondly called Fine Pass All. For those whose passion is to probe into the vault of history and gaze in wonderment at what they hold, the old residency museum beside the old consulate building, built in the 1880s to accommodate the then British consul for the Bight of Benin and Biafra, is a vault for preservation of antiquities, artifacts, and relics of historical importance. It is interesting to note that these two buildings were prefabricated in Britain and shipped in pieces to Old Calabar, where they were permanently erected. Along the Ikom Ogoja highways, intriguing sights of carved stones in low relief in different shapes representing human figures called the Ikom monoliths, locally known as Akwanshi, meaning dead persons in the ground, can be found. Visitors are often fascinated not only by the quality of the craft, but also by the creativity, and indeed, some believe these carvings are not the handwork of mere men, but of nature. Cruising along the rich expansive regions outside the city metropolis to the north, towards the mangrove creeks of Adiabon, you have the rare chance to combine business with pleasure at the ultra-modern resort of Tinapa. Great and dynamic initiatives like these has propelled Cross River State to huge international acclaim, especially in the areas of promoting the concept of community ecotourism, a concept that is proving to be the harbinger of hope for tourism, culture, wildlife, and ecological harmony alike. A short drive from Baby Airstrip takes you to the foot of the Obudu Mountains range, known in local parlance as Bottom Hill, and this is where the fun begins. You would like to acclimatize in the cool crystal clear showers of the water park and experience the sensation that registers a feel that awaits you up the hill. Recreation facilities like swimming pool, water slide are also in use. You could also climb up further to the famous Obudu Plateau, 1,576 meters up through 11 kilometers of winding roads with 22 breathtaking bends, one of which is called the Devil's Elbow. Well, it's just a name. Or would you rather be taken up like a fairy prince by cable car? The longest in Africa, the first in West Africa, and one of the longest in the world. This will lift you up into the sky and up to the top of Obudu Plateau, up behind the clouds, far from the maddening crowd. You will be amazed of the temperature and the unique scenery up there throughout the 15-minute ride up the mountains. Up there, the Nigerian Trendsetters Cross River State Government is continuing to add to nature's endowment with a lot of exotic tourist facilities. The ranch is for your relaxation or for business in a cozy, friendly environment. Away from the hustle and bustles of everyday business life, follow the trend of the picture-perfect 9-hole golf course, a squash court, 2 tennis courts, a modern gymnasium, all to the delight of pleasure seekers. A true lover of nature can experience soft showers of Agbokin waterfalls and bask in the freshness of unusual vegetation around the falls. Visitors are led to the top of the waterfalls with the fascinating sight of 7 rivulets running from the top and entering into the Cross River. An explorer's overwhelming experience reaches new heights at the Kwa Falls, some 25 kilometers from Calabar in Anagije Village, Akanpa local government area. Tourists can experience sensation provided by these vicious sparkling natural water tumbling down the hilly igneous rocks formation, which is typical of our tropical region, stretching through 234 steps from the plain on top of the bays where the water empties itself. The visitor can be tuned to a complete union with nature as they enjoy the view of the beautiful tropical forests of mahogany and spruce trees that line the region and the undulating landscape. These African drill monkeys are very rare species found only in Cross River and in a few other locations in the world. Their species are nonetheless preserved in the Afi Mountain Sanctuary. Cross River State Government is uniquely aware of her tourism responsibilities to guests, and she is equipping herself to fulfill these. Canopy walkways are now put up in the heart of the state's forest resources. One in Wancho Drill Ranch, where the rare species of monkeys still inhabit, and the other at the Obudu Cattle Ranch Resort Hills. There is a strong commitment by managers of these resources to individual comfort, personal service, and informed safari activities. The state's entire natural heritage is being run responsibly with the unique branding structure, offering a range of activities and facilities guaranteed to delight everyone, from discerning adults to teenagers. Every visitor in the midst of Cross River State's amazing natural heritage has a wonderful experience and a lifetime story. The annual Obudu Mountain Race has continued to grow bigger and better, attracting participants from all over the world. Everyone looks forward to the Calabar Festival, full of exciting activities. This has become a major reference for creativity and style the world over. Whatever your taste, whether you are a historian seeking for relics of slave trade, or that of pleasure seeker searching for the romance of these present age, set against a lush, beautiful paradise of the South, with colorful places, splendid waterfalls, a warm, friendly, and vibrant people. Come to the South. Come to Cross River State, a place for the world beauty queens, esoteric pleasure seekers, the cool, calm, and collected tourists. Whatever your desire, come to Cross River State and you will definitely find your place. Welcome to the nation's paradise.